Let's look at how we would work with a sampling distribution of means if our population is not normally distributed. So in this example, we're going to look at restaurant bills at a given restaurant. They have a mean of $32.40. They have a standard deviation of 8.16. These are population values, so that's some population mean, some population standard deviation. And then something they tell us is the shape of our distribution is heavily skewed to the left. So our population looks something like this, which intuitively makes a little more sense for restaurants. I mean, if you think about like people who go out to dinner regularly and have a full meal and drinks, that's what happens most often. But then maybe there's people that sit at the bar and just have an appetizer or a drink. So you'll have these few very small bills that come through, but mostly large bills of people visiting and having a full meal. Anyway, explain why you cannot determine that a given bill will be at least $35. So what this is trying to get us to do is we have a mean, we have a standard deviation. It's making us want to go to GeoGebra to use this mean and the standard deviation, and then go and find this probability of being more than or equal to 35. However, one key piece of our notation here is n. And even if you look in GeoGebra, it shows us a perfectly bell-shaped curve. We can't use that since we know our curve is actually left skewed. So we can't find probabilities of skewed distributions. So because we don't actually have that it's normal, we can't find probabilities with skewed distributions. Can't find probabilities with skewed distributions. So, can you estimate the probability that the next five bills will average at least $35? So now what we're doing is instead of looking at how an individual bill behaves, because that was just a given bill individually, now we're looking at what if we take five bills and average them. And this whole idea of averaging with a sample size, that's linking to our sampling distribution of means. So to know if we can estimate it, we need to check our central limit theorem. So do we have independence? Do we have randomization? And do we have a large enough sample size? So independence, how one bill behaves should be independent of the other. So we'll assume we're good with independence. Randomization, this isn't very random since they're taking five bills in sequence. What that could suggest is time of day or something, that maybe it's not quite random. We're going to go ahead and assume it's random enough. Now for our sample size, what we need is a sample size larger than or equal to 30. Since we have a skewed distribution, we have to meet this sample size. However, our sample size is 5. Which is too small. So since our sample size is too small, we can't calculate this probability. So can you estimate this probability? Nope, because our sample size is too small. If we take the average of next 50 bills, so if we up our sample size, we'll assume we still have independence, we'll assume it's random enough, and now with a sample size of 50, we're at larger than or equal to 30, so we're good. So if we take that average, then would all the conditions be met? Yes, because now we have a large enough sample size. So using the sample size of 50, we're gonna build our model and then find some probabilities. So defining our parameters, when it asks for the parameters, it's asking what is the mean and what's the standard deviation for our distribution. For the mean, we just copy down our population mean. That's kind of the punchline to these sampling distributions. Mean, you should just be copying from the population. Standard deviation, you always have to do a little bit of a calculation. So 8.16 divided by our sample size, the square root, 50, which is a 1.154. And we could get a picture going using this. We could even look in GeoGebra for what it looks like, but we'll have 32.4 in the middle. And then numerically, we could get an idea of what one standard deviation away looks like. If we're adding that 1.154, we'd have 33.55, 34.71. If we move below, we get an idea of what this number line distributes like with that standard deviation. So how likely is it that the next 50 bills have an average of at least $35? So we want to use this distribution that we just found because we're asking for the probability from a sample size and how the average behaves. So we're going to have a mean of 32.4, standard deviation 1.154, and we want to find this probability of being at least 35. So in this distribution, and you can even see from our number line here, 35 is out there somewhere, and we want this area to the right. It's going to be a small probability based on just being a small area from the picture, but let's go to GeoGebra to get an exact value. So set my mean to 32.4, standard deviation 1.154, and then we want to be going to the right of 35, which is a 0.0121. So there is a 1.21% chance the next 50 bills have an average of at least $35. So to find our probabilities, we need to show that we have a bell-shaped curve, and the way we show that we have a bell-shaped curve is by proving that central limit theorem. If we meet all of those conditions, then we have it. So in part B, we failed, so it was going to still be skewed. In part C, we passed with that larger sample size, so we know we can draw a picture with the bell-shaped curve. Find the two values for the middle 50% of the average of 50 bills. So what we're asking here is, using this distribution of averages from a sample size of 50, if we have our distribution, what would it look like to have a middle 50%? What two bill values are going to be the bounds for that? So we're going to get two numbers out. We did a similar example to this when we talked about the normal model. In GeoGebra, you're going to get stuck in that you can't set area between two values. But what we can use are these two separate areas. This area to the left, which is 0.25, and this area to the right, which is also 0.25. So if I want to find x1, I'm looking for this probability of being less than or equal to some number. I don't know what it is yet. And that area should be equal to 0.25. And then for x2, I'm going to do the same thing, but now I'm going to look above that value and have that area above be 0.25. So let's go to GeoGebra. We're going to go to the left-hand side, and I'm going to change that area to 0.25. What that gives us is about 31.6216. So that tells me what value is landing right here. And then for the upper value, I'm going to do the same thing, but go to the right-hand side and change that area to 0.25. Which will give us a 33.1784, which tells me this upper bound right here. So to have the middle 50% of the average of 50 bills, so the middle 50% of the average of 50 bills is between $31.62 and $33.18. So this is what we can do if we have a distribution that's not normally distributed for our population. The main extra step is just really checking that we have a large enough sample size, but then calculations within GeoGebra work exactly the same.